And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 3 Blind. I am the RPG chick, and I think we're gonna head to Palaven. We are here. I noticed this is flashing and these are flashing. Right, so we're supposed to rescue the Turian Primarch, and we're gonna do that here in Apian Crest. I'm not sure what goes on because we have a Reaper here. Pretty cool. Search and rescue. The Normandy is equipped with a new and improved scanning pulse that can detect objects of interest. Use this to uncover war assets, artifacts, intel, and fuel as you fly around the system. Be aware, however, that each time the pulse is used, the chance that Reapers will enter the system to investigate is increased. If a Reaper enters the system you are in, flee and wait until you have completed a mission before returning. So maybe we should do this mission first before we scan? Because I guess they mean flee as in flee the system. New and improved scanning pulse. How do I use the pulse? Oh, scan. Which is the other button. Got it. So I'm not gonna scan yet. Let's see what we got as far as fuel. Should be full. Yes. Is Senus planet? Okay, so we can see the names of the planets before we even get there. And this orbit is the... No, not the Mass Effect. The Mass Effect is not in an orbit, apparently. So what's this outer planet? Datriox. So I guess we scan the whole system and not planet by planet. I'm thinking... I see it turning. Did they even turn in Mass Effect 2? I don't know, I can see it turning. Anyway, Datriox is a small rock and ice planet with an extremely thin nitrogen-based atmosphere. Exploited for its metal deposits, the planet's iridium was marked as part of Palaven's strategic reserve during the Krogan rebellions. Its facilities have been maintained to this day. Scans indicate the Reapers did not destroy these surface facilities. It is possible they either did not see them as a threat or plan on using them for their own purposes. A few Reaper destroyers serve as a skeleton crew here, backed by a capital ship in case the Turians attempt to retake the planet. How many Reapers generally attack a planet? You know, that's why I keep thinking, how many of them are there? Because we were in that one city and we could see three or four of them. And then ground troops showed up. And that was just in the one city. So what do we have? Hundreds and thousands of them all over Earth? Alright, so that's interesting. They call it a journal. So I'm just gonna look at all these planets. And then we'll do our thing. And then we'll scan. That's like a best idea. Let me just look here. So we have... Oh, we don't have probes? Okay, we scan, but not with probes. So you have 1,000 fuel and 25,000 credits, which is... I was aware of. Essenus. Acinus is a hydrogen helium gas giant that was home to a substantial Turian garrison defending the planet's fuel infrastructure. It once held a distribution center for anti-proton-based fuel, as well as the more common helium-3 collectors. The garrison is now gone. The Reapers drove the Turians off and destroyed all available machinery. The Reapers appear to have moved on. A few Volus ships are now visible, likely present to scavenge the wreckage. At least we can still look at all the planets, which I always enjoy doing. Impera. The small planet Impera is a hothouse of helium and argon, the latter a product of decaying radioactive materials. Robo mining was once lucrative here, but like the rest of the solar system, the only remaining veins are inaccessible by cost-effective means. The planet is named for Atron Impera, the Turian Machiavelli, whose ambitious political philosophies led to her reign as regent in the continent-spanning Nialan Empire for more than a decade. She famously combined citizenship tiers with a meritocracy rather than a caste system, which served to strengthen her empire. This practice fell in and out of favor for centuries before its revival early in the Turian's Age of Nation-States. The Reaper invasion largely ignored Impera, sending only a token force to destroy the scientific equipment around the planet. So you have little notes about the Reapers everywhere. We'll go here last. Oh, that's Palaven. The only thing on this planet that isn't silver are the Turians. It's all too clear they're made of steel. These were Alliance hero John Grissom's impressions of the Turian homeworld Palaven, seen by humans for the first time during the First Contact War. The Turians' martial attitude permeates every aspect of Palaven society, from architecture to art to politics. It's no surprise that their homeworld was never occupied by an invading force until now. The Reapers, aware of their enemy's reputation, brought overwhelming force to Palaven and did not hesitate to bombard cities that resisted, and all of them resisted. The dust and smoke from pulverized cities is now a breathing hazard across much of the planet. Water and power supplies have all but vanished. Still, the fight here has cost the Reapers dearly. Alliance Travel Advisory. Palaven's weak magnetic field means solar radiation levels are greater than those found on other habitable worlds. Human visitors are advised to wear enviro suits or other radiation protection when visiting Palaven. Population 6.1 billion. Orbital stations 35,000. Population estimates are pre-invasion. Capital is Cypratine. That's horrible. Billions of people. You can't even breathe in this on this planet. That's like freaking terrifying. Unfortunately, you can miss planets because it doesn't say how much is explored or not. I mean, I guess you find stuff not on a planet though. I don't know. It works a little different. Kalax. Like nearby Aventin, Kalax was named for an ancient philosopher and author. But where Aventin wrote for the military leaders of tomorrow, Kalax focused on those who feed, clothe, heal, and arm the soldier. Her enormous tome, Service, features a lengthy chapter on laws that form the basis of the Turian concept of citizenship tiers. Kalax is lower in temperature than Aventin, and its minerals were thus exploited first. The Turian defenses on Kalax were not completely destroyed, which is unusual. It may be that remnants of the scattered Turian fleet regrouped using the planet for cover and eliminated the satellite-hunting Reaper destroyers before their mission was complete. More likely, the destroyers found a way to compromise the defenses through wireless hacking, and the unmanned drones present now obey them. And finally, Aventin. Aventin is named for a tactician philosopher whose treatise on leadership is known by every Turian youth who pays attention in class. It is a small, hot rock planet surrounded by a haze of methane and helium. It was thoroughly mined for valuable minerals in the early days of the Turian space age, and since then has had little to offer. Aventin's token spy satellites and defense drones prove no match for even a small Reaper presence, and best reports suggest they have been eliminated. Damn. Did I look at this one? I should have. It sent us, right? Yeah. Yeah. Well, for some reason I thought I had forgotten that one. Now I see this one. That's just a glow, right? It looks like there's two lines. Alright, let's go to Manet. Palaven's largest moon has been shrouded in secrecy since the dawn of the Turian space age. During the Krogan rebellions, the hierarchy classified nearly all data on Manet and its sister moon, Nanus, because they feared the Krogan could use the moons as weapons by smashing them into Palaven's service. Mass drivers, right? However, some information has leaked out. Images of Turian bases where personnel walk without envirosuits indicate advanced infrastructure, likely a network of subterranean tunnels with powerful mass effect field generators that retain heat and atmosphere over swaths of the surface. The Reaper's plans for bombarding the bases were met with fierce resistance by the Turian fleet and the moon's anti-aerospace defenses. With their easy victory stalled, the Reapers deployed a variety of ground units to take the bases one at a time. The Turians have the advantage on the moon, but the Reapers have the patience to slowly grind them down. With every base captured, the Reapers deny the Turian fleet another place to repair or refuel. Look at all this stuff. Orbital distance classified. Orbital period orbits Palaven every 33 days. All this other stuff is classified. How odd. Like we can't just find this out by examining the planet. Alright, let's land. Right, so we've only got Liara and James. Right, because Ashley is out of she's out for the duration. Oh, she's got an armor bonus. Cool. Okay. Yep, I'm confirming. It's all I can bring. Onto the shuttle. Alright, so power recharge speed is minus 200% because of the weight we have. I don't know. Is there a way to, like, not bring a weapon? Like, to leave the whole sniper rifle behind? They don't use it. So he can't use this stuff. He can only use assault rifle and a shotgun. And I have not messed with their weapons at all. Vindicator. I'll go with Vindicator. I want to make sure that took place. Katana. This freaking thing's heavy, Crusader. Capacity, fire rate, damage. You know, I'm gonna have him take the katana because for all this weight. Oh, it's very accurate though. Well, let's see if we take it. Okay, so I can give him that. Alright. Can we modify this as well? No. Okay. And Liara can only use submachine gun and heavy pistol. M3 Predator 1. This is better in a lot of ways, so. Alright. Yeah. N7 Eagle. Rock you like a hurricane. Shuriken. Fire rate. I'll let her have the N7 Hurricane, which you can modify. I guess when we find a mod, we just have, you know, it's not just one mod. Like, we can mod that with everything. Like, we can put that mod anywhere, is what I'm saying. Which doesn't make a lot of sense, but hey, I'm not gonna complain. Reduces weapon weight by 50%. Or the scope. Yeah, both. Two points. I don't really use stasis, really. I use it just a couple times with her, so I'm just gonna hold on to her points for now. And James, my man. Carnage. Knocks him down, or increase recharge speed. Increase damage to armored units, or increase damage. I'm gonna do the knockdown thing. I like that. I just have to remember to have him use it. Alright, confirm. Those Turian vessels? Oh, damn. Holy crap, guys. We're on the other side of the planet, aren't we? Right, towards the moon.
Oh no. No. Palaven. We have an old friend there.
Holy hell. They're getting decimated.
Damn.
Strongest military in the galaxy, and the Reapers are obliterating it. Was it like this on Earth?
Yeah.
Yes. Shepard. I'm so sorry. Yeah.
Thanks.
Commander, Yelzi's getting swarmed.
James, open that hatch.
Landing zone, LZ. Okay, this is different. Incendiary. Oh, she's on this side this time. Husks. Warp. Pistol. Be clear. Oh, damn, it's a freaking Reaper right there. Looking around for stuff. And looking around at stuff. Hold on. Huh, my little map indicator thing isn't working. I can't go over that. Yeah, I can't go over there. That's pretty high. Maybe over this stuff? No? Alright, never mind. Why the hell am I up here? So this is the limits of my environment. Unless I can climb up this stuff. I'm just rolling. Hi.
Soldier, which way to your commanding officer?
Straight ahead and around the corner, past the first barricade.
Could it be my good buddy? Camp is that way. Damn. Could it be Garrus? Let me in there. Oh, I can go in here. Yeah. Ah, salvaging spare parts, just like old times. I hope I, like, you know, can't get stuck on stuff like in the second game. Can I drop down here? The game won't let me kill myself. I don't want to go the long way.
That Reaper is enormous.
Saw bigger ones on Earth. A whole lot of them.
Yeah.
Goddess,
Goddess, yeah, Goddess is right. Okay, there's gotta be a way around. Oh. This way. Can I put my gun down? I haven't been able to do that yet, which makes me wonder if it's possible if I just bound it to a different key by mistake. Use cover storm. Let's reload. You mean there's actually no button to put my gun away? Excuse me. Swap weapon, maybe? Maybe I could swap to just nothing. I don't think there's a way to put my gun away. I'd like to, so I'm not aiming my gun at friendlies. Find commanding officer. Oh, Garrus. Is that obvious? I heard that. Buddy, Buster. I like the exploration part here.
Reinforcements haven't arrived.
Tobestic. Ground report. Knowledge of the terrain is our only advantage here, and that's not going to last forever if they keep throwing their forces at us. We'll hold this area as long as we can. I'm linking my transponder to the life signal monitoring system of the unit's suit. If it goes out, send another unit here ASAP.
That's an order.
Oh, we got a Viper here. Viper. Where's the Viper? The Viper is a semi-automatic rapid-fire sniper rifle manufactured by Rosenkov Materials. Rosenkov developed a patented automated release system that assists with thermal clip ejection, shortening the Viper's reload time. This rifle is popular with military snipers who appreciate a long-range gun that can snap off multiple shots in the blink of an eye. Yeah, sounds good. But how good is it? Well, it's very accurate. Damage is kind of middle of the road. Let's see what else we have. This is much better here. This is with the mod, I'm guessing. Well, I can't change the mods here. I have to go to like a weapon table or whatever the hell they call it. I don't really use the snipers. I mean, it's not to say I won't ever use them. not in the habit of it. Try it again. I'd just rather... not walk around with my gun out like this. There's no need for it. I don't know how to put it away. Maybe I'll look it up, just in case there is a way to do it, and I'm not aware.
Get your men up on that north barricade.
Corinthus?
Yes, sir.
Sergeant Bartus, find a way to get that comm tower operational.
Bartusk?
Sir.
General?
Commander Shepard, heard you were coming, but I didn't believe it. General Corinthus.
Better believe, baby.
I've come to get Primarch Fedorian.
Is there a problem?
Primarch Fedorian is dead.
Oops.
His shuttle was shot down an hour ago as it tried to leave the moon.
Okay, so much for the Council helping
us.
That's
gonna complicate things.
How are things here in Minae? I really want to say this first, but if I say that, then that will go away, right? So how are things here in Minae, whatever?
How bad is it, General?
We just lost about 400 men in half an hour.
Damn.
We set up camps on this moon as an advanced position to flank the enemy. A sound strategy. Just...
irrelevant.
Exactly. The sheer force of the Reapers seems to make them immune to that sort of tactic. The Primarch and his men found that out the hard way.
I'm sorry for your loss.
I'm sorry. I hear he was a good man.
And a friend. He would have been an outstanding diplomat.
So what happens now?
The Turian hierarchy provides very clear lines of succession.
Right. General Corinthus?
With such heavy casualties, it's hard for me to be certain who the next Primarch is. Palaven Command will know. However, at the moment, contacting them is impossible. The comm tower is out.
We have to restore the comm tower.
Husks are swarming that area. We can't get close enough to repair it.
We will find husks.
Don't worry, General. I'll get your tower operational.
Thank you, Commander. I'll take care of things on this end.
All right, let's go.